Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on signs and symptoms of a faulty fuel rail pressure sensor. Now, the fuel rail pressure sensor is often shortened to simply the fuel pressure sensor, and as the name suggests, this sensor is found on the fuel rail of your vehicle, and it monitors the pressure inside of that fuel rail, which is important for maintaining proper pressures for your engine in order to maintain proper air fuel ratios and fuel injection. Ultimately, it's a pretty uncommon failure point. A lot of fuel rail pressure sensors are actually built and tend to last the lifetime of the vehicle. However, of course, being an electrical sensor, it is prone to its share of problems. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common signs and symptoms of a bad fuel rail pressure sensor. Number one on the list, we have the check engine light. So this is very straightforward. But again, as an electrical sensor, any sort of faults or issues with that fuel rail pressure sensor should immediately trigger the check engine light and store an associated fault code in the vehicle's computer. So one of the best ways to identify issues with the fuel rail pressure sensor is with an OBD2 scanner. Simply plug that into the OBD2 port of your vehicle, read the codes, and those codes should help point you in the right direction and identify if the fuel rail pressure sensor could be the issue. A few common fault codes associated with these problems are P0190, P0191, P0192, P0193, and P0194. Now, this isn't a totally exhaustive list, and there are also other fault codes that could indicate and point to potential issues with the fuel rail pressure sensor, but those are a few of the common fault codes that can help point you in the right direction. So again, check engine light and those associated fault codes are going to be one of the main symptoms of a bad fuel rail pressure sensor. Moving on to our second most common sign and symptom of a faulty fuel rail pressure sensor, we have no start problems or cranking no start. So if you're not getting proper fuel rail pressure, then it could be possible that pressure is too low and actually not sending enough fuel to the injectors, which would ultimately mean you don't have enough fuel moving into the engine and into the cylinders. And so that's what could cause the vehicle to crank but not start, or potentially start and then quickly stall out. And so just any general issues with starting the vehicle could point to an issue with the fuel rail pressure sensor, and then in turn, the fuel rail not actually getting enough pressure and ultimately not delivering enough fuel into the cylinders of your engine. For symptom number three, have a couple things lumped together here. That is rough idle, misfires, and poor overall performance from the engine. So again, with a faulty fuel rail pressure sensor, it's very possible and likely that the fuel rail actually isn't getting enough pressure and the vehicle isn't able to maintain a proper fuel pressure and injection cycle. And that's ultimately going to lead to a lot of various issues, all starting with misfires, poor AFRs or air fuel ratios. And that's all going to lead to a lot of various symptoms, like again, rough idle, poor performance, low power, stalling, etc. So anything with poor engine performance or along those lines can certainly indicate an issue with that fuel rail pressure sensor and ultimately the vehicle not maintaining proper pressures inside of the fuel rail. Moving on to our fourth and final symptom of a faulty fuel rail pressure sensor, we have poor fuel economy. So in the last couple symptoms that I discussed, we assumed with a lot of those symptoms that the engine is receiving inadequate fuel pressure in the fuel rail. However, on the other hand, you could also get excessive pressure inside of the fuel rail and ultimately lead to richer AFRs and too much fuel entering the cylinders, which will ultimately lead to poor performance and poor fuel economy. Now, this can be one of those symptoms that's a lot tougher to notice in the short term, but if you are tending to notice that your fuel economy has gotten a little bit worse and you have some of these other signs and symptoms, it could indicate that you have an issue with your fuel rail pressure sensor and the rail is getting too much pressure and ultimately injecting too much fuel into the engine, ultimately leading back to this poor fuel economy. So really, that wraps up the most common signs and symptoms of a faulty fuel rail pressure sensor. Once you've identified this as the main problem and underlying cause of the issues with your engine, then it's time to go ahead and get that fuel rail pressure sensor replaced. When it comes to replacing the fuel rail pressure sensor, fortunately, this is a pretty straightforward job. The fuel rail on most vehicles tends to lie at the very top of the engine bay, right near your fuel injectors, and the sensor simply lies on that fuel rail, so it's generally very accessible, just underneath an engine cover a lot of times. So it's easy to access. The fuel rail pressure sensor, depending on the vehicle, tends to cost somewhere in the ballpark of about $25 to $150. And again, right there on the top of the engine bay, so any DIYers, anyone comfortable working on vehicles and engines, should have no problem knocking out this replacement in as little as 30 minutes or under an hour in the driveway or garage. So very simple DIY and relatively inexpensive part. If you end up going to a repair shop, it's likely you'll spend about $100 to $200 on labor, so this could get up there to being a $200, $300 repair if you're buying the part and going to a repair shop for the job. But otherwise, in the grand scheme, pretty minor issue and inexpensive repair. Anyway, guys, that wraps up this video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.